foot. Remember me, I hope you played that number on water last year.
I remember you, brother.
Thank you, my friend. I appreciate the hell out of it.
I've been raised in Lexington, so I've always heard about Gatewood ever since I was a kid, probably. And then going to UK games, seeing him hold his signs on the side of the road, you know, I always ask, you know, what's that guy? What's he doing? And, you know, I finally explained it. Then the best thing, you know, to learn about him when I read his book, probably I picked it up because I was interested in Gatewood and then read it the next day. And, you know, by then, you know, I was already following him wherever he went. Basically, because everything he supported, you know, were things that I was talking about that nobody else stood up for.
I first heard about Gatewood at the Bluegrass Army Depot where I worked, and I read some of his stuff, and I knew that he was the guy after my own heart.
I knew of him when he first came to Lexington, his reputation as such a good attorney, and his fight for freedom for us common folk. And I jumped on the bandwagon for him when it became apparent that he was my kind of man.
So what did you do for your 60th birthday?
What day was that? What did I do for my 60th birthday? Oh, I think my kids came over and bought me some presents. That's my 60th birthday, I announced for governor. That's when I had my announcement over in the January 23rd, so I announced for governor. I'd forgotten what I'd done.
They can go ahead and just enter all the information that's going to be in there.
Thank you.
I think that's it on my books, brother. I got another one out of the car.
I mean, I thought it was one of the better books I've read just from an entertainment standpoint. I mean, he talks about, you know, everything you could want in a book, really. He wraps it all up, and it's the fact that it's true and that he actually left a lot of the more interesting stories out of there. You know, you could imagine what kind of book he could really write.
I love it. It's the best book I've, or story, or best reading that I have done since Mark Twain's Stories of Huckleberry Finn. Good, easy reading and very, very informative.
I loved it. It was just, most books when it's related to political, you know, subjects and stuff, it's so boring, and the way it's laid out, it's just, you know, they're basically speaking about themselves and their own achievements and, you know, ways that we can fix things that are unreasonable.
Do you want to talk about his book? Or?
Well, yes, I'll start. I really enjoyed Gatewood's book. It was at times as outrageous as Gatewood is on a semi-regular basis. And after reading it, I realized that he has lived many lives. And maybe that's the thing that helps him connect with everyday people.
Why did you decide to write a book?
Well, you talk about the last free man in America. Well, I had presented myself to the public on many occasions in the political arena and had been snubbed and boycotted by the typical media. Felt like my positions were never fully described, never fully presented in the marketplace of ideas. One of the blurbs from Mr. Paul Krasner says that one of the refreshing things about the book is that I don't take myself as seriously as I take my issues. So I thought that was pretty good observation.
Do you think he's been unfairly labeled a one-issue candidate?
Yeah, that's been my biggest issue with people I've talked to.